the Western world came to learn the ancient secrets of the occult. Our answer lies in the remote vastness of Asia.
Come with us to Tibet, land of mystic enchantment, where we find a haggard figure entering a strangely peaceful chamber.
I've searched for months, but now at last my quest has ended. You, old man, are you the one I seek? Are you called the Ancient One?
Yes, I am the Ancient One.
Then you're the one with the magic healing power? I need you. You have to help me.
Be patient, child of the Western world. I heal none save those who deserve it. The power of my magic must never be wasted on the undeserving. First, you must prove you are worthy.
You can't refuse me. I won't let you. I've traveled too far, waited too long. What?
Stop. I will permit no act of violence here. None may lift a hand against the Ancient One.
He's holding me motionless above the ground just by a gesture. It's uncanny.
And now I shall peer into your brain, into your memory, and learn the truth about you. As you in the past, in America, in a hospital, you are wearing the frock of a doctor. Ah, you were a famous surgeon named Stephen Strange. You were proud, haughty, successful. But you cared little for your fellow men.
Brilliant operation, Strange. Oh, your patient wants to thank you.
I can't be bothered. Just be sure he pays his bill.
Money, that was all that interested you. All you cared about.
My mother's a cripple these days, and my younger brothers just won't make it if I can't get back on the job.
Sorry, if you can't pay my price, I can't help you. Find another doctor. I don't take Medicaid patients.
To you, the problems of others meant less than nothing.
Hey, there he is. Dr. Strange, Joe Gibbon, Amalgamated Radio. What are the chances that you'll be joining the team of volunteer doctors leaving for Peru tonight?
Sorry, I'm not interested in charity work.
Dr. Strange, but with your skill, they might save thousands more lives.
When they're willing to pay for my talent, I'll listen. Not until then. Now, if you'll let me through, my car's waiting.
But what is this? The scene now changes. I see an auto accident on a lonely road. The victim is alive, but the victim is you.
We got here just in time, Joe. Get an ambulance, quick.
Car 95, we got a crash here at 61, Highway 61. That's mile 7272. Send an ambulance, please.
10-4.
10-4.
You recovered in due time. Your life was spared, but you suffered a terrible blow.
Strange, I don't know how to tell you this.
Speak up, man. I can take it. What did the x-rays show?
Well, although your hands seem to be all right, the nerves have been severely damaged.
You mean...
I'm afraid so. You'll never be able to operate again.
No. No, I don't believe you. You're lying. You must be lying.
Stephen, even though you can't operate, you can work as a consultant.
Never.
Work as my assistant.
Stephen Strange assists nobody.
And so you went into seclusion. You spent your days brooding as bitterness filled your soul. You lost track of time and became a drifter, little more than a human derelict. Then, one day in a dingy bar, you overheard two sailors.
Yeah, I heard of the ancient one. They say he can cure anything by some magic power.
If you ask me, I say he's just a legend.
The ancient one. Many times in the past, I too have heard this name mentioned in whispers. Can it be that there is some truth to the legends? History tells us there have been men with certain powers. What if he is such a man?
The rest is easy to deduce. You sought me for my healing power. But I cannot help you, for your motives are still selfish. And yet, I seem to see a spark within you, a spark of decency, of goodness, which I might be able to fan into a flame. There, I release you from your spell. If you stay here, study with me. Perhaps you will find within yourself the cure you seek.
I should have known. It was just a waste of time. You're nothing but an old fraud. Your little parlor tricks don't impress me. I'm leaving. Say, where'd that snow come from? It wasn't there before. I could never make it down the pass now.
No, you will have to remain until it thaws.
That snow wasn't your doing. Oh, what am I saying? Pretty soon I'll convince myself you do have magic powers.
Naturally, man of the Western world, you must not allow yourself to believe in magic. It wouldn't be seemly. And now, inasmuch as you must remain here until the snow thaws, my pupil Mordo will show you to your room.
But weeks pass and the snows do not. Dr. Strange begins to explore the halls and chambers of the mountain retreat.
Mordo, what a creepy-looking character. All he does is study those scrolls and recite his dirges. What a waste of time. I should never have come here in the first place. I'll ask the old man if he knows how long it takes the snows to melt around here. Looks like he's asleep. Say, what's that vapor swirling around him?
The vapors of Valtor. I am being attacked by an unseen enemy. The vapors were spawned by magic, and only magic can dispel them. I summon the powers of the Vishanti by the spell of the dread Dormammu. In the name of the all-seeing Agamotto, all thy powers I summon.
At that very second, in a blinding flash of light, the swirling vapors vanish into nothingness.
Be gone, forces of darkness!
If I hadn't seen it, I'd never believe it. What was that? What did it mean? What force dispelled it?
I cannot explain to a non-believer, but I must always be on guard. The forces of evil are ever pitted against me.
Look, I'm not a surgeon anymore, but I'm still a doctor. I can see that you're weak. You're ill. You need rest.
That is impossible. I must remain until I can find a successor. The evil forces must not be allowed here on Earth.
If I stay much longer, I'll end up becoming a believer. I've got to get away before I become a part of this madness. The snows are almost gone. Maybe I'll be able to leave soon. Say, what's Mordo up to now?
Dormammu, accept my incense offering. Let the force of your power descend upon my enemy. Let him feel your fatal touch. I beseech you, Dormammu.
The doll surrounded by vapor. It looks familiar.
Dormammu, do not fail me. Ah, the prying stranger has found me. You wonder what it is I do?
It's a replica of the Ancient One. He's trying to slay him. Ah, his own pupil. Mordo!
I'll tell you, because you are too weak to stop me. I have learned much more than the Ancient One suspects. And once he is slain, I shall be the only master of magic.
You won't get away with it, Mordo. I'll tell him. He'll toss you out.
Fool! You think I am helpless? You think you can defeat my plan? Behold, see how easily I can cast a spell upon you. A spell which will prevent you from ever giving away my secret.
A vapor is forming. From out of nowhere. It's coming towards me. It's formed itself into a clamp. Ah, run.
I can't speak. I can't speak. But wait. It isn't really there. And yet I'm unable to speak. So there is such a thing as magic. And this is proof of it. But although I can't speak, I can still move. I'll...
By the powers of darkness, I command you, weak, unknowing Western dog. How helpless you are before the magic of the ancients. And now I shall finish with you. There. None can see your iron clamp or the force that surrounds your wrists. But you feel them. You know they are there.
Later, after Mordo has left.
It's probably nothing more than simple hypnotism. I won't let him stop me. I'll go to the Ancient One and... Ah! Those bolts of pure force. They're trapping me. It was no bluff. Mordo does possess the power of magic. But what can I do? I've got to warn the Ancient One. I've got to save him. But how? Mordo's speaking to him now, and the Ancient One doesn't suspect a thing.
You have shown much progress in your studies, my pupil. You have mastered many of the mystic arts.
That is good, for I am eager to follow in your honored footsteps.
No, I've got to warn him.
Listen to me. Who dares intrude?
It's you, the witless blunderer from the far western continent. If you have words to utter, speak.
He knows I cannot. His spell is stopping me.
Send him back to the new world, Ancient One. There is no place for him here.
How smug he is. He knows I can't even expose him. Oh, I've never hated anyone so much.
And so, alone and helpless, Dr. Stephen Strange stands and broods.
At last I see the power of sorcery. I cannot give up. Mordo must never be allowed to defeat the Ancient One. For if he should, what would happen to the world as we know it? I'm only subject to Mordo's spell if I try to warn the Ancient One. Yet I'm able to speak of other matters. So there's still one hope. If I, too, can learn the secrets of magic, then I can battle Mordo with his own weapons. Ancient One, a favor, please. I wish to accept the terms you offered me some days ago. I wish to study at your feet, to be taught your knowledge, to prove myself worthy of the mystic arts.
Ah, at last I have reached the real Dr. Strange. I knew there was good within you, if I could but bring it to the surface. I accept you, my child. You shall be my disciple. First, I release you from Mordo's spell. So, now you are free to speak, to act, even as before.
You mean you knew of Mordo's spell?
Of course. The pupil can have no secret from his master. But although he is evil, I prefer to keep Mordo here, where I can control him, rather than banish him. One day, my son, when I am gone, it will be your task to battle Mordo to the finish. You have been tested, and you have passed your baptism of fire. But the path ahead of you would be difficult and fraught with danger. Do you still wish to continue?
Yes, Ancient One. I do wish to continue.
And so it began. The days passed into weeks, to months, to years, as Dr. Strange studied the long-dead mystic arts. Slowly he changed. Slowly his life took on a new, deeper meaning. Slowly he prepared himself for the epic battles ahead, the battles which could only be won by Dr. Strange. Be with us again next time for more of the occult adventures of Dr. Strange, Master of the Mystic Arts.